Like Peter and they that were with him said, Master, the multitude throng you and press you. Look to somebody and say, you got the press.
You got the press.
And say you, who touched me?
All right.
And Jesus said, somebody has touched me.
All right.
For I perceive that the virtue has gone out of me.
Uh-huh.
The word virtue.
All right.
And when the woman saw that she was not hidden, she came trembling and falling down before him. She declared to him before all the people for what cause she had touched him and how she was healed immediately. And he said to her, daughter, be of good cheer.
Uh-huh.
Your faith has made you whole.
Right.
Go in peace. While he yet spoke, there comes one from the ruler of the synagogue's house, saying to him, your daughter is dead. Trouble not the master. But when Jesus heard it, he answered him, saying, fear not, believe only, and she shall be made whole. And when he came into the house, he permitted no man to go in, save Peter and James and John, and the father and the mother of the man. And all wept and bewailed her. But he said, weep not, she is not dead, but sleeps. And they laughed him to scorn, knowing that she was dead. And he put them all out and took her by the hand and called, saying, Maid, arise. And her spirit came again, and she arose immediately, and he commanded to give her meat. And her parents were astonished, but he charged them that they should tell no man what was doing.
All right.
Look to somebody and tell your neighbor beside you, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Y'all ain't saying it. I don't think y'all really came to our church. Now, if you could just say it like the football game is on, and like your favorite team is winning, like you were sitting in front of the TV on yesterday. I know I wasn't the only one. But if you could just tell them, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
We perceive a whole lot of appearances of God.
We perceive a whole lot of appearances of God.
Come on and bless the Lord in this. So here's a little with the story. The Bible says that there was a woman who had been dealing with an infirmity for over 12 years, and this thing had consumed her.
Uh-huh.
Which means that this thing had basically gotten the best of her. Have you ever been in a circumstance or in a position in your life where it seems like your trials and your tribulations have gotten the best of you? And have you ever been in a particular thing in your life where it seems like on every hand that you're trying to fight, look like no matter how hard you're fighting, look like the devil is winning? Oh, I wish I had somebody who could be real about it in this place. The Bible said this thing had consumed this woman for 12 long years. That's a long time to be dealing with this, your blood. And ladies, especially for you all,
mm-hmm.
I've gone to every doctor that I could, and I still can't find no help. I tried everything that I could. I've gone to every roof worker in town. Come on, y'all might as well die.
Praise God.
I see the mountains. I see the trials.
Yes.
I see the tribulations.
Yes.
But it ain't gonna stop my prayers.
Right.
I see my children acting crazy.
Yes.
But it ain't gonna stop my prayers.
Right.
I know right now my mind might not feel stable as I like it to be. But it ain't gonna stop my prayers.
Right.
I know I might not have the money I desire to have.
Right.
But it ain't gonna stop my prayers.
Right.
Is there anybody in the house determined today? She would have never reached for the hem.
That's right.
Amen.
Because she could have reached for his sleeve.
That's right.
But the sleeve wouldn't have caused the reaction.
Okay.
She could have reached.